first question is, how long has your club been in existence?
¿Qué cuánto tiempo tiene el club existiendo?
Desde el año 45.
1945.
Okay. When does your season begin?
March.
Okay. So what is your weekly schedule? How many practices? Do you play on weekends only?
Or yeah, we play on weekend only, and we take a practice like Tuesday to Thursday.
Okay.
It's three days in a week.
3 days. Okay. Most of the players have families or are students or?
Yeah, most of the players in here, que si alguno estudian o tienen, most of the players in here working here.
How many teams in division do you
have? Nine
teams. Okay. Where are you right now?
We're in the sixth
position. So who is your biggest rival?
Like Tenerife. Marlins. Yeah. Because they got too many players born in Venezuela.
Yeah.
And they bring it like, and they got a lot of family in Spain. Yeah. And they come here to play like Hispanic guys.
Okay, so they're like the Yankees.
Something like that. Yeah,
okay.
Like that.
So that is my next question. So how many foreign players are
there? Like 16 guys. 16. All the roster. In Spanish, like 8, 9, something like that.
Okay,
the other players born in Dominica, but they got the baseball to Spanish.
Okay, so 6 or 7 Dominican born.
Yes, something like that.
What type of player do you normally bring over? Pitcher? And
pitcher.
Former minor league player?
Depend the player they need it for them.
Okay, so usually they have professional baseball
team. Yeah, like they got a good experience outside and bring together. For
what about a college player that played at the top NCAA Division I school?
No, but they need like statics, you know?
Yeah.
They see the statics,
yeah.
And they see it, and maybe if they need it, like shortstop, outfield, catcher, pitcher.
Decadence visit, next stop, Sample Land.
So, did you come here to play baseball?
Yeah, I came. I was playing in college,
yeah.
In the United States.
Yeah.
And then because I have my Spanish passport, I came here with the Tenerife Martins first,
yeah.
In 2006. But I came, play, and then I went back.
Yeah.
So, being here since 2010.
Okay. And are there other imports on the team, other non-Spanish players?
Yeah, we have like four of them.
Okay.
We got three guys coming from Venezuela. Mm-hmm. They play there the professional ball, winter ball there.
Yeah.
And then they come here, play here. And then after this week, we're going back there to keep playing there.
Okay, so they're here for baseball primarily, mm-hmm. Not for other reasons.
No, just for baseball.
Okay, cool. Are any of them paid or any expenses?
Yeah, well, the team tried to give someone like help because it's not professional.
Yeah.
Having contracts here,
yeah.
So they try to help them with some money,
or maybe a job or something.
No, like it's more money,
more like
money than jobs
to pay their food expenses.
Yeah, kind of food expenses. For trying to reach the things that I can't see. Oh yeah.
That's just how I feel. So, what position or positions do you guys typically import?
Oh, I mean pitchers and catcher, because this league is very, very important to have a pitcher. So other positions, maybe if the team already has the
guy that can throw, can pitch the first game. Maybe another position he can focus on that. They primarily bring, or try to bring, pitcher and catcher.
I don't want to be right if you tell me I'm.
Just one or two more questions about the how is baseball received in Spain? I see the fans that are here are very supportive. Like they're
today,
into it. But
today, Sunday, it's less fans. Yesterday was a bit more because we played Saturdays at 6 p.m. most of the games. So Sunday, people here in Spain are going to eat with family. So at 11 o'clock, it's hard to find people here. At least it's a good game. I mean, this team that we face right now is not one of the top teams. Okay? And so not bring a lot of people.
Next stop, Baseball Barcelona. Until then, a little chill time. Tell me a little bit about the history of your baseball club and the stadium, this beautiful stadium.
About the baseball club, we started in 2011 because we was part of the FC Barcelona system, and with the new president, they changed the program and take out the baseball. So we created the same people that we work for FC Barcelona baseball section. We create the new club, Barcelona Baseball Club. So to follow with the history, because it's an history that more than 80 years. So we thought that was really interesting for all the kids, and they come follow to practice baseball because we was the only club in the city.
And then there's this beautiful stadium. This was hosted the Olympics in 1992.
Yeah.
Can you tell us a little bit about that and how that was?
Yeah, this was the practice ballpark for the Olympics, because it's in the Olympic ring. So finally the council, when the Olympics finished, they kept the field to promote the baseball, to improve baseball in the city also.
When does your season begin?
Usually our seasons begin early than the rest of Europe. Most of the times it's middle March. And we usually play until the early August, end of July or the first week. This year we finish the first week of August.
Okay, and how many games are there in total?
36 games for a regular season. And also depends on the clubs. If you play the King's Cup, Copa del Rey, you have two games more, the semifinals and final. And also here, usually in Catalonia, we play like between 6 or 10 precision games. We start early February. But here the weather is nice.
The weather is nice.
We can start to practice at the beginning of January outside. So yeah, we play some precision games between the teams of National League here, Samboy and Viladecans, and sometimes we play against the teams from south of France, Montpellier.
Many foreign players playing for your club?
Yeah, we have this year usually
five foreign players in the national league here in Spain. You have five spots and you usually always cover. Yeah. We have two guys from the States, one from San Francisco and other one from Chicago.
Yeah.
We have a Japanese guy also, mm-hmm. and two Venezuelan players.